Hey, and welcome to our new mini series on Hikvision's latest video intercom screen, and we're calling this the Android panel. So, as you see on the screen, there's the model number, and that you can see the panel there. And what we're going to be doing is going through all the features and showing you how to configure it in various setups, and just to have a little couple of a few extras like adding ringtones and apps, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So, what is this screen to start off with? Okay, so traditionally, when you have a Hikvision intercom system, you would have a screen on the inside. So when it rings, you can see who's at the door, you can unlock it from there, or you can just communicate through that. Okay, so it's been a pretty basic screen, but now they've got this new one out, and it has basically two really good plus points to this screen. Okay, so the first plus point is it has HitConnect, the app for your security, built into the unit. So what does this allow you to do? This allows you to have your intercom, your CCTV, and your alarm, if it's an Axe Pro alarm system, all on the same device. So you can get all your notifications, you can view live, you can basically control everything from one unit. So that's very, very handy device if you have all your intercom, I mean all your security on one from Hikvision. So that's very handy. And the second big plus point about this device is you can add in two basically Android apps. So I think this is limited to 100 megabytes right now. Please, someone let me know if I'm wrong. But that's mo a lot of apps you can install. So you can go for something like Nest or all this home automation, and you can add that to the device too, and really have everything under one unit, which is really, really handy. So a great job here from Hikvision, a lovely panel. We're very impressed of it. And what we've done is a 7-part, 8-part series, showing you how to configure it and use it. And in this episode, later on, we're going to show you the actual unboxing of the item and the physical aspects of it. Okay. So let's go through a few things and show you what's coming up in the series. All right. So this is the door station. We'll be using the doorbell. Okay, so you don't have to use this doorbell. There's different ones, and the screen will basically operate in the same way. Okay, just for your information. Okay, and we be using a switch like most people, most setups. So this is like almost like the hub of the unit, where everything connects to. Okay, so this is the first episode you're watching right now, and we're going to go to an unboxing very soon, and you'll be able to actually see the unit, and that's coming up very shortly. In the second part, we'll be doing some very boring stuff, updating the firmware. It is boring, yes, oops, but it's highly, highly, highly important you do this. It's probably the most important step if you want to set up this intercom correctly. Okay, so update the firmware. It's quick, it's easy, it doesn't take long. So, highly recommend you do that. Okay, and on the third part, this is the setup we have. So we have our doorbell connected to our switch, connected to our panel, and we're going to be setting this up so through the panel. So everything is brand new, essentially, and we're going to set up everything just using the touchscreen panel, entering the IP addresses and things like that. Well, it's going to figure it out for us. We just enable DHCP, nice and easy. So very easy to set up via the touchscreen. More or less anyone can do it. Okay. And then we'll be setting it up through IVMS 4200 as well. This is a bit more complicated, a bit more buggy, maybe. Things can, I wouldn't say go wrong, but yeah, you might find it a little bit more tricky because they have made it really easy to set up through the panel. But for complicated setups, you will need to learn IVMS. So that's recommended for people who really want to learn how to use all the features. Okay, and the panel is Wi-Fi. So I have showed you how I'm going to show you how to set it up through Wi-Fi as well. So you can put the panel really wherever you want, but the rest of the system is connected, is hardwired. And the next part, I'm going to show you how to put on HitConnect on the panel. Okay, so if you've got an existing account, perfect. You just log in with your details, nice and easy, and I'll show you how to use that. Okay, then I'm going to show you how to set up Android apps. Okay, so we're going to upload a couple of apps to the device and quickly show you how to use them. Okay. And in the last part, Traditionally, if you've seen our last series, just a bit of fun, we're just going to add some custom ringtones to there. So you can add any ringtones you like, but we've got a few on our website you can just download. Okay, and that comes that will be the end of the series. So I've already actually made all these videos, so they're ready to come. So gonna flip over now to the live view, show you the unboxing, and hopefully you guys watch the series and enjoy it, and I'll see you there. See you later. Cheers. Bye. Hey guys, and so here is our Android station. Okay, so as you see, it comes in a pretty plain gray box. Nothing too special about this, so let's crack on and open it up. Okay then, so you get the usual bits and bobs from Hikvision. We've got a back plate here to mount it on the wall, a few cable connections, a couple of screws, and a power connection. I'll show you how to use that later, that's if you wanted to set up the screen using Wi-Fi. Okay, and we have instruction manuals, which are usually not much good. But we're going to go ahead and look at the main panel. Okay, let's take off the plastic. Okay. Alright, already I can see that it seems pretty solidly built. Unlike a couple of the other panels, which are quite thin and flimsy a little bit, this is solid plastic. They've done a good job here, and it looks nice. I can see this on someone's wall, looking pretty good. So that's the front of the panel. So take a look at the back. Okay, so we have your connections here. We've got the LAN cable. You've got a power connection here, and if you see closely, there's a mini USB connection here. I'm not too sure what you could do with that, but I'm going to find out hopefully soon. And you've got your RS485s and other bits here. And if you want to insert a micro SD card, there we go. So that is our panel, and we're going to be doing a lot of different setups here. We're going to show you how to configure it, get it going, and we're going to add some apps to it. So look out for these for the apps. And show you how to use HitConnect, which is built into the unit, obviously, which I've said. So hopefully stay tuned and see you soon on other videos. And bye for now. Cheers.